Good evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me, Gert Retief. And tonight we are starting a three-part series on the cask collection from Glenfiddich, and that is also a retail version of it. I picked this up at the Vienna International Airport a week ago. And we are going to do a review on all three in the next couple of weeks, starting off with the vintage cask. So a little bit of a background. I do like the Glenfiddich 12. I did like the 15. I think the 18 was the best for me. I haven't tried the 21-year-old, so that is also going to be on my bucket list for the future, to get a bottle of the 21-year-old, which is part of the core range. So on today, we are going to look at the Glenfiddich vintage cask, quite light in color. So For this review, I did a little bit of research, and there's a reason why I did some research on it, because I did realize that a full bottle of this vintage cask is going to cost you anything between 90 to 100, even a little bit more than 110 euros. And when I looked at the bottle, I was looking for an age statement. Why is this so expensive? And I didn't find an age statement on it. So I did a little bit of research. And unfortunately, their own website didn't give me any information with regards to the age of the whiskey. And I had to do a little bit of digging, and I found a third-party website that was talking about this whiskey, and they were giving me an indication that it's a 15-year-old single malt. Now, for me, that is a little bit a strange thing, that I have to go look at somebody else's webpage to get this information. I would have loved to log into their own website, and they would have given me information on the filtration, the coloring, and the age statement. So, in this case, nothing. They just tell me a little bit of the that's retail. They give me a little bit of a nosing and tasting notes, and a little bit of the casks that they are using. So to give you a little bit of information on the maturation, they are using, and I quote, hand-selected European and bourbon vintage cask, and then married into a vintage Solera vat. So what does that mean? Well, for me, it doesn't really mean anything. The only thing that I can think of, it's an old vat of probably sherry casks, and they would also been use old ex bourbon casks that can be refill bourbon casks and old sherry casks. So for me, that means all the good things are stripped out of the casks already, and they are left with the tannins. So that is the idea when I get vintage old. And so how old is these vintage casks? I don't know. How many times did they refill it? I don't know. Maybe I am overthinking this thing. Maybe I am in a complete wrong direction with this thing. But for me, it is a little bit of a strange thing that they're saying. But this is a retail bottle. So you're going to pick it up probably at the airports and probably at some other shops, online shops might get this as well. As I said, nothing on coloring, but it's quite light for 15 years, if it's 15 years. So quite light on the color, so not much color added, if I did add color, but it did not give me that information. And of course, at 40% ABV, it's probably chill filtered. And it cost for a full bottle between 90 and 110. So I am going to give it a quick nose, a quick taste. I'm going to give a little bit of a score, maybe. And I'm going to give you my impressions on this one. So on the nose, it is quite nice on the nose. So I get a sweetness again. It's not an overly sweet. So if it was a comes from an ex sherry cask, I don't get a lot of the sherry notes. So, and that also, if I look at back at my presumption that it's being reused full cask, that also maybe point to the fact that there is not a lot of the sherry influences. So I do get a sweetness. This is supposed to be a peated whiskey. So again, not much information on it. What I did find is when they put it in a barrel, it's about 25 ppm. And by the bottling time, you are left with about 15 parts per million. So if you do get it, it's going to be a little bit light on the smoke. In fact, I don't get any smoke on it. And I think because I'm quite climatized already to heavy smoke, so I do not find it. So I do get a little bit of a sherry note. But it's a hint. And when I get a little bit of a sulfur note, the burnt match or a rubber note. And I got not much on the alcohol at 40% ABV. And I do apologize, we are still working in my house, so the noise is driving me nuts. So I also get a little bit of a hint of a dried apricot. And a hint of a raisins coming out. A little brown sugar. A little bit of a vanilla note also. And a little bit of a toffee note. And I presume that all comes from the ex-bourbon casks. So on the nose, it's everything that you expect from an ex-bourbon cask. It's everything that you expect to have a little bit of a European oak cask. It's quite soft. It's nothing aggressive, but it's also nothing special. I do get all the nice flavors coming out, but you will find it in most of the whiskies. I did expect to see a little, to get a little bit of the stronger notes coming out, but there's nothing, but quite mild. So quite nice on the nose, I think. Everything is toned down. Everything is quite balanced. So there's nothing just jump out and say, big vanilla, big sweetness, big toffee notes, quite balanced. And I kind of enjoy the nose on it. So on the taste, cheers. Very sweet. Caramel coming out, hint of the vanillas coming out. I would say even going into a little bit of a toffee note. So quite sweet on the second sip. More toffee. More sweetness. And now I get a little bit of an oak coming out. And I expect that from the European cask to give a little bit of an oak kick. Not unpleasant though. But I think there's something that will definitely build up. Yeah, by the fifth or fourth sip, the oakiness will definitely start taking over. Definitely European cask finish. Yeah, and I was right. The sweetness is not so much anymore, and the oak is taking over, and it's now becoming quite bitter. Loads and loads of tannins that were pulled out of this cask, the resins, the oakiness, and it's becoming a little bit unpleasant. And it also gives me a little bit of a dry mouth feel. I think this would have been nicer if I added maybe just a 3% of alcohol to 43, or maybe even a 46% would have made a big difference in the nosing and in the tasting. So let me just try one more time. Yeah. The nose for me was a lot more promising. In fact, I still like the nosing, but the tasting is falling quite flat. Very one-dimensional, two-dimensional, a little bit of a sweetness in the oak. And maybe a hint of burnt toffee. Not really pleasant on the taste. So my thoughts, is it worth it? Definitely not at that price. Although they do say it's a 15-year-old, so price-wise, I would say that it's competitive for a 90 to 110 euros for a 15-year-old. It's a little bit high for me, but definitely not going to pay that for this whiskey. So maybe somebody that do like a little bit of an oak, I think this one is for you. But at 40%, I'm hesitant to tell people to go buy it, as I will not be buying this again. So thank you very much for watching. I'm not even going to bother scoring this one. And if I have to give it a score, it's going to be a very low score. Did not really like it. So please remember to like and subscribe. And I see you next time. Cheers.